examples of English Gothic architecture in the United States. It came in piecemeal. The whole thing is like, this is a Gothic church pulled out of the 13th or 12th or 14th century and all of a sudden placed in modern America. That was the architect's intention. So the lights are out now, which actually this is a very rare opportunity because you'll see the sharp blue, like in France, of the
gorgeous.
Yeah, Michael.
The parish would put in after time the windows, and then all the other little side chapels and the rare dose we see up there. I'll turn the light on in a little while. Was all continually added on. It was really the nickels and dimes of the Irish who lived on Third Avenue to First Avenue. So we've inherited this gorgeous church. Really gives St. Patrick's a run for its money. Also, too, the architect was a gentleman by the name of Bertrand Goodhue, and the firm was Goodhue and Cram, I think, and he also designed the chapel at West Point. It's his work. Now, they've cleaned that up there not too long ago, and it's kind of interesting because it's beautiful, but it's also squeaky clean, which is, we've been mixed. We had to do a little cleaning and restoration of the back window, maybe about 6 years ago, 8 years ago, yet the rest of the place has a certain amount of soot that's come on it because they used coal here in the 20s, 30s, 40s. We didn't have steam heat yet.
Right.
So, some of the frames of the windows are black, but that also makes the glass pop out more. The colors pop against the black, against the dark. So, you know, we're kind of in between. Do we restore and make it clean, like new, or do we kind of let the seasoned effect stay? Now, of course, if something's buckling or cracking or leaking, we're going to have to fix it and clean it and repair it. Case in point, the back judgment window. The friars at the time,